everybody. Welcome back to another Daily Drop here on TarHeelIllustrated.com. I'm THI publisher Andrew Jones, and the topic today, Carolina football. Not something a lot of fans are feeling great about that follow the Tar Heels. The Tar Heels have lost three consecutive games, and they've been kind of in weird fashion. Ugly against JMU, ugly second half at Duke, and just explosive plays galore against Pitt. And in the second half, the Tar Heels could not get off the field on third down. But while a lot of people are focusing on Carolina's defensive struggles, and rightfully so, they are 129th in the country in most explosive plays allowed at 33. That is alarming. There are a lot of alarming things, but I'm going to take you over to the offensive side of the ball, because it's not real pretty there either, especially in the fourth quarter of the two ACC games Carolina has played so far. And I'm actually going to stretch something back to last year. It's a head scratcher, and it's something that Carolina fans need to know. I guess it's red meat. That's not the intent. The intent here is to just cover the team and roll the numbers out as they are. And here's what they are. In the loss at Duke, Carolina did not score in the fourth quarter. Duke scored 14 points. In the loss Saturday against Pitt, Carolina did not score in the fourth quarter. Pitt scored 10 points. So, in the two ACC games, Carolina's opponents have outscored it 24-0 in the fourth quarters. They lost by 1 point to Duke and by 10 to Pittsburgh. So they led going into the fourth quarter in Durham. They were tied going into the fourth quarter at home in Chapel Hill against the Panthers a few days ago. They did not handle either fourth quarter well. Lots of things went wrong, including the offense's inability to get points. Now, I'm going to go back a little bit further. I'm going to take you to the Minnesota game, because I like to evaluate a power conference team against power conference teams. And the Tar Heels in their six games this year have played three contests against power conference teams. So in the opener at Minnesota, UNC won that game 19-17. The Tar Heels did not score a touchdown in the fourth quarter, even though they moved the ball one time, twice got field goals, still didn't cross the goal line. So Minnesota, which had a field goal that period, in the fourth quarter, of the three games this season against power conference teams, the Tar Heels have been outscored 27-6. They beat Minnesota, but the Gophers missed a field goal as time expired to lose the game. So it could have been three touchdown-less fourth quarters and three losses. Let's go back to last year. The bowl game against West Virginia. No touchdowns for Carolina in the fourth quarter. West Virginia outscored them 10-0 in the fourth quarter. So in the last four fourth quarters against Power Four teams, Power Conference teams, the Tar Heels do not have a touchdown, and they have been outscored 37-6. Let's go back another game against a power conference team last year. That's the regular season finale at NC State. The Tar Heels did not score in the fourth quarter there. State didn't either. State had a huge lead, kind of coasted and salted that thing away. But the reality is, in the last five games North Carolina has played against power conference opponents, the Tar Heels have not scored a touchdown. They have the two field goals at Minnesota to show for it, but outscored 37-6. Let's go back to the Clemson game, which was a week before NC State. Now, Carolina did cross the goal line in the fourth quarter at Clemson. Amarian Hampton had a three-yard run. Carolina went for a two-point conversion, did not make it. That was with 7:03 left in the game. That is the line. Right there, 7:03 left in the fourth quarter at Clemson, a Carolina loss. Since then, the Tar Heels have played 82 minutes and 3 seconds of fourth quarter football against power conference teams and have not scored a touchdown. So while the focus is an awful lot on the defense's issues, can't get off the field, explosive play, one explosive play after another, 36 missed tackles in the last two games combined. And even offensively, a lot of emphasis on the missed fourth downs, some of the decisions that were made. The reality is this is not a good football team in the fourth quarter. It wasn't late last season, and it's not this season. If you want an indicator about where things are, look to how teams finish games. Mack Brown and his staff have pushed the whole finish thing. That was one of the messages throughout the offseason because they closed poorly the last 2 years. Part of finishing is finishing those games. They're not finishing games on either side of the ball. That's alarming, and it's also reality. And it's also something that needs to change immediately, or this season could get out of hand in an ugly way, because most of the games Carolina plays moving forward are likely to be fairly competitive. There's not much of a difference between what UNC puts on the field and what Georgia Tech will put on the field this weekend. Virginia will in Charlottesville, FSU in Tallahassee, Wake in Chapel Hill, at BC, and State at home. Not a whole lot of difference there, but finishing strong gets you over the hump in most of those games. Heels have not done it. We'll see if that changes. Right now, the indicator is it's probably not super likely, but we'll find out. Five games in a row against Power Conference teams, no touchdowns. Let me know what you guys think about that. I probably can imagine this isn't piling on, guys. It's digging this stuff up and telling you what the story is. And this is another prong to a story that is not going great right now. If you have not subscribed to our channel, please make sure you do that. Let your Carolina Tar Heel friends know that we're here. Have them come on over. Sign up as well. Head on over to tarheelillustrated.com. Just $8.33 a month for a one-year subscription. Make sure you hit the notification bell every time so you get an update every time we post a video, which is often. And by the way, we've got the basketball football overlap now. So if you like both sports, we're just rolling stuff out like you wouldn't believe. Anyway, I'm AJ, and I appreciate you guys stopping by.